In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's readings. Today is the 25th of March, Wednesday of the fourth week of Lent, and we celebrate it, the solemnity of the Annunciation of the Lord. Let me read the Gospel of the day. The Holy Gospel according to Luke chapter 1 verses 26 to 38. At that time, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom, there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I know not man?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your kinswoman Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month with her, was called barren. For with God nothing will be impossible." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's picture in our mind the Gospel scene of the Annunciation. The solemnity, my dear friends, of the Annunciation celebrates the coming of the angel Gabriel to the Virgin Mary to announce to her the special mission God had chosen for her in being the mother of his only son. We are continually reminded of the importance of this feast to our salvation in various devotional prayers. Two examples that highlight the importance of this feast are the joyous mysteries of the Rosary and the Angelus. This promise of God that was made to King Ahaz came to its fulfillment at the Annunciation to Mary. Immaculate Virgin, Jesus received his human form to become the perfect sacrifice and sin offering according to the divine will of God the Father. Through the atoning sacrifice of Jesus, the imperfect sacrifices and sin offerings of bulls and goats came to an end. For these, offered according to the law, were imperfect in nature. Now that the former law, the covenant of the law, has been permanently abolished, the second, the covenant of grace, has been established. And so, by God's will, we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The feast of the Annunciation invites us to enter with Mary into a quiet contemplation of the promise of salvation, which was first pronounced by the prophet Isaiah, and which was later accepted by Mary, and fulfilled and manifested in Jesus. But for now, we are invited to be with Mary and say our yes to the Lord. The feast of the Annunciation reminds us that we are sinful and we need to be saved from the clutches of the evil one. And we need Jesus to come into our hearts and to be made flesh in our lives in order to be saved. And that is the meaning of the celebration of the Feast of the Annunciation. Brothers and sisters, pray the psalm as prayer. The psalm echoes the words of the readings from Hebrew, that is today's second reading. What God wants is not a lot of rituals. God wants people to accept the gift God has for them and respond by seeking to do the will of God. Mary was willing to do so. She said yes to the Lord. And as we pray, let's declare grace that we say yes to the Lord. Psalm number 40, verses 7-11. Response: See, I have come, Lord, to do your will. You delight not in sacrifice and offerings, but in an open ear. You do not ask for holocaust and victim. He said, See, I have come. Response: See, I have come, Lord, to do your will. In the scroll of the book it stands written of me, I delight to do your will, O my God, Your instruction lies deep within me. Response: See, I have come, Lord, to do your will. Your saving help I have not hidden in my heart. Of your faithfulness and salvation I have spoken. I made no secret of your merciful love and your faithfulness to the great assembly. Response: See, I have come, Lord, to do your will. Your justice I have proclaimed in the great assembly. My lips I have not sealed. You know it, O Lord. Response: See, I have come, Lord, to do your will. My dear brother and sister, today as we celebrate the Annunciation feast, let's pray for Mary's intercession during this corona. O Mary, you always shine on our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who are in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You, salvation of people, know what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that as in Cana of Galilee, return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Brothers and sisters, at 12 Vatican time, Pope has asked all Christians, irrespective of the sect, to pray the Our Father, 30 in the evening. And you calculate your own time. If you are, you know where you are, and join Pope Francis in praying the Our Father for those who are suffering from coronavirus pandemic. At 12 Vatican time, in India it will be 4:30. We are requested to join Pope Francis in praying Our Father. And today, as we find in the Bible diary, Ina Sikvera from Sakinaka, Mumbai, Janet De Silva from Bengaluru are celebrating their birthdays. We wish them happy birthday, and also the others among the listeners who celebrate their birthday. Wish you all a happy birthday. God bless you. And we pray for the departed soul of Alice D'Souza Kanjurmarg from Mumbai, and also all those who died due to coronavirus. Pray for God's blessing now. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Stifan Perera, Carmelite priest, wishing you all a happy feast, and also praying for you, promising our prayerful support in this time of difficulty. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.